I remember I had a mentor. Many years ago, I was playing at a restaurant, a club, a bar called the Five Oaks. Remember the Five Oaks down on Grove Street? And I had two people in the audience, and he came up to me and he said, "I know you. We've met a couple of times through various friends, and I'm doing a production of Cabaret, and I'd like you to. Would you like to be my assistant?" And I said, "Sure." So I went and played for him, and he said, "Well, your left hand needs a little bit of work." And I was doing a show in Florida called No Way to Treat a Lady, Doug Cohen's musical, West Palm Beach, and I rented a piano for the whole time I was down there, practiced that cabaret score every day, came back and played for Peter, and this is Peter Howard. The man I'm talking about is the wonderful Peter Howard. If you don't know who Peter Howard was, they called him Mr. Broadway. He wrote the dance music beginning his first show. He worked on Plain and Fancy. He taught Rex Harrison to speak sing his songs. He wrote the dance music to Carnival, Hello Dolly, Annie, Barnum, Baby, and a little show. Well, Bob Fosse said, "We need a vamp here. Can you come up with something, Peter?" Peter said, "How about this?" And he said, "Yeah, that's good. So Peter wrote the Roxy Vamp. So Peter wrote the dance music to Chicago, and he also conducted many of the shows, and he also wrote the dance music to a little musical you may have heard of called Hello Dolly? No? Anybody? And when you hear dancing, you hear the ba-bum, that little dance music. That's actually a song Peter wrote. He incorporated it into his dance music. So Peter and I went to Italy. Perché parlo italiano, I was his assistente musicale. And we went to Italy and did cabaret in Italiano, so I had the whole score in Italian, which is nice. With Bjork Lee, you all know Bjork Lee? Yeah. We just won a Tony this year. Bjork's become a dear friend. Bjork and I are going to Tokyo next month to coach high school students who've been filmed by NHK, by Japanese television. You may all know that I travel quite a bit to various countries around the world. Really? Yeah. After I got back from Tokyo, I'm going to Shanghai to do an original musical in Mandarin, Kashur Woheshwar, Indiar Putamwa, Kashur Shaldabuha. I speak a little Mandarin. So now back to the show. My next performer, again, I've known a while, but I remember vividly when she became the youngest female girl ever to win a Tony Award. And I remember she had her Tony acceptance speech, and I had this friend who was an agent, do teary eyes or whatever, "I'd like to thank Francis Del Duca." And I was like, "Francis Del Duca, I know him. Oh my God, 1 degree from Daisy Egan, that's cool." And I didn't meet her for many years, but I met her. She was friends with Peter Howard. She worked with Peter, right, Daisy? I think she'll tell us in a second. Let's bring her up here. Ladies and gentlemen, Tony Award winner, Daisy Egan. There she is. There she is. Looking like she looked when she won her Tony. How adorable is Daisy? Looking, how cute is this? Is this pretty down here? She's like, "I don't want to be cute." But,
didn't look exactly like this when I was
young. She didn't look exactly like this. Maybe not this dress, but yeah. But you knew Peter Howard, right? The dance music.
Sure.
Yeah, sure. You might say so. Because Peter introduced me to you, and...
Oh, then yes.
But I just remember that, and Daisy's one of the few people here today, including Faye and Carol, who performed my show in Los Angeles. We did it when she was around 8 months and 31 days pregnant. And I mean, the baby was out to you guys.
It was crowning. Like,
the
stomach
was like this.
Crowning.
It was really, I was just sitting there going, this is
going
to happen
any minute
now. It was really any minute now. Remember that? So, no, I forgot.
I remember.
But, I wanted to tell about Daisy, about what she's going to do tonight. So you all know that I have this very large collection of sheet music, so I found, if you didn't know, I have a lot of very large collection of sheet music. So I brought these sheets in, because Daisy said, "I want to do this song," and I said, "Oh, I have the an original sheet of it." You all know this song? This is called You'd Be Surprised by Vic Berlin. And that's one sheet of it. You take one sheet. And this is another sheet of lyrics. And there's another sheet of it. There's a music stand for you somewhere. And there's another piece of music. And then here's another one. You all remember? Anybody remember Bonnie Baker? Now, Bonnie Baker, Faye, you said you sang with Bonnie Baker, right?
It was a movie.
You're the one, and she was in a movie. There's Bonnie Baker.
Baker.
You survived. We Bonnie Baker.
Seven.
She was seven. But I thought this would be a fun thing for Daisy to do. So Daisy, you want to say anything first? Hold it. You guys can all hold words tonight. I don't care. It's fine. You guys are fine with that, right?
No. What I do want to say is, since this is a benefit for the Actors Fund.
Oh right, I do want to say that too.
Yeah. This well, I figured benefit. At some point you would. But
that's right.
It's okay. They've already spent their money.
Well, when I was when when I was setting this up, I said, I said, I want to make this a benefit for the Actors Fund, because I've done a lot of work for them over the years providing sheet music, and they are such a wonderful organization. If you don't know much about them, find Tim Pinkney in the audience. Where are you, Tim? Tim's here somewhere. Right there. You can ask Tim. Tim will tell you more about the Actors Fund. He's here from the Actors Fund. But Daisy, the Actors Fund helped you quite a bit.
Yeah. When I was 6 months pregnant, I lost my insurance, and this was before Obamacare. And pregnancy is a pre-existing condition. So is being a woman. Being a woman is also a pre-existing condition. So I couldn't get insurance. And also, another really fun fact about insurance and being pregnant is that it used to be, before Obamacare, having a baby was the number one cause of bankruptcy in this country. We love women in this country. So I was 6 months already, so like that was gonna happen. About it, and I was like, this is what it's like to be pregnant and uninsured in America. Tom Viola of Broadway Cares Equity Fights AIDS read my blog and called the Actors Fund and said, you need to help her. And the Actors Fund, I'd been raising money for them since I was a child, but they stepped in and they covered my COBRA for the rest of my pregnancy. Because if they hadn't, I would have put a cork in there, and I'd have a four-year-old inside me right now. So thank you to the Actors Fund for that. Here we go. Johnny was bashful and shy. Nobody understood why Mary loved him. All the other girls passed him by. Everyone wanted to know how she could choose such a beau. With a twinkle in her eye, she gave this reply. He's not so, he's not so good in a crowd, but when you get him alone, you'd be surprised. He isn't much at a dance, but then when he takes you home, you'd be surprised. He doesn't look like much of a lover, but don't judge a book by its cover. He's got the face of an angel, but there's a devil in his eye. He's such a delicate thing, but when he starts him to squeeze, you'd be surprised. He doesn't look very strong, but when you sit on his knee, woo, you'd be surprised. At a party or at a ball, you'd have to admit he's nothing at all, but in an easy chair, you'd be surprised. Mary continued to praise Johnny's remarkable ways to the ladies, and you know advertising pays. Now Johnny's never alone. He has the busiest phone almost every other day. A new girl will say, he's not so good in the house, but in a bench in the park, you'd be surprised. He isn't much in the light, but when he gets in the dark, you'd be surprised. I know he looks so slow and so dreary, but you don't know the half of it, dearie. He looks as cold as an Eskimo, but there's fire in his eyes. He doesn't say very much, but when he starts in to speak, you'd be surprised. He's not so
That song's gonna, next year, or the year, 2 years, that's gonna have its 100th anniversary. It'll be 100 years old, that song. And speaking of old songs,
it was very, very controversial.
Risque at the time in 1919. But I wanted to talk about a series.
I hear Selena Gomez is gonna do a cover.
It's very Stephen Rivers. And a couple of years ago, I decided to do a CD of a bunch of standards, the most obscure song being Toot Toot Tootsie or Bye Bye Blackbird. And I recorded them, did a piano track, did a second piano track, did a third piano track, very elaborate piano, added drums, added a bass. And my friend said to me, why don't you get some of your famous friends to do duets of previously unrecorded songs from Broadway musicals? You can say this is the premiere of this song, and it might help sell some CDs. And I got nobody you've ever heard of, Laura Osnes, Rebecca Luker. Heather and I did what we just heard tonight, our 2 for 2, which of course was recorded already, but we loved it, so we decided to do it. And Daisy, God bless her. I had a bottle of it, but Daisy and I came up with a song from a musical called Here Goes the Bride by Johnny Greene. Remember Johnny Greene, who wrote Body and Soul? This was a musical, Here Goes the Bride, and our duet was called My Sweetheart Tis of Thee. And it was an adorable little song. So I'm calling the CD Me and My Girls. Get it? We haven't put it out. I've mixed it, mastered it around 3 years ago, and I've just been taking time to write the liner notes, so I promise it will be out soon. But would you do another number for us, Daisy?
Yeah, it's not going to be that one.
It's not going to be that.
But that was a great story. He's like, you're fired. It's Michael Lavine and Friends and Daisy. I love you. It's 2:45. There's no one in the place except you and me. So set 'em up, Joe. I got a little story you ought to know. We're drinking, my friend, to the end of a brief episode. Make it one.